devastation you see here was caused by the explosion of the bomb above this zero point. Only the strongest buildings are left standing, and they are gutted. Looking north from zero point, this is what was left. Looking east, the camera records a scene of complete devastation in the immediate area. To the south, these are the ruins. Looking west from zero point, the same complete leveling is evident, the same inability of structures to withstand atomic power. This barren area, 0.3 miles from zero point, once contained the main Japanese military headquarters. The barracks were utterly destroyed. Most of the military personnel of approximately 20,000 were wiped out. Shadows of the posts on Yorozoyo Bridge indicate the direction of the explosion. 0.6 miles from zero point, the bridge floor is etched except where shielded by the railing. Outlined in the surface of the bridge is the shadow of a pedestrian which tells its own meaningful story.
Plutonian Ode. What new element before us, unborn in nature? Is there a new thing under the sun? At last, inquisitive Whitman, a modern epic, detonative. Scientific theme first penned, unmindful by Dr. Seaborg with poisonous hand, named for Death's planet through the sea beyond Uranus. Whose tholic or father this magma-tiered lord of Hades, sire of avenging furies, billionaire, hell king, worshipped once with black sheep throats cut, priest's face averted from underground mysteries in a single temple at Eleusis, spring green Persephone nuptial to his inevitable shade, Demeter, mother of Asphodel, weeping dew, her daughter stored in salty caverns under white snow, black hail, gray winter rain or polar ice, immemorable seasons before fish flew in heaven, before a ram died by the starry bush, before the bull stamped sky and earth, or twins inscribed their memories in cuneiform clay or crab flood, washed memory from the skull, or lion sniffed the lilac breeze in Eden, before the great year began turning its 12 signs, ere constellations wheeled for 24,000 sunny years slowly round their axis in Sagittarius, 167,000 times returning to this night. Radioactive nemesis, were you there at the beginning, black, dumb, tongueless, unsmelling blast of disillusion? I manifest your baptismal word after 4 billion years. I guess your birthday in earthling night. I salute your dreadful presence, lasting, majestic as any god. Sabaoth, Jehovah, Astapheus, Adonais, Elohim, Yao, Yaldabaoth. Aeon from aeon, born ignorant in an abyss of light, Sophia's reflections glittering, thoughtful galaxies, whirlpools of star spume, silver thin as hairs of Einstein. Father Whitman, I celebrate a matter that renders self oblivion. Grand subject that annihilates inky hands and pages' prayers, old orators' inspired immortalities. I begin your chant, open-mouthed, exhaling into spacious sky over silent mills at Hanford, Savannah River, Rocky Flats, Pantex, Burlington, Albuquerque. I yell through Washington, South Carolina, Colorado, Texas, Iowa, New Mexico, where nuclear reactors create a new thing under the sun. Where Rockwell war plants fabricate this death stuff trigger in iron baths. Tanger Silas Mason assembles the terrified weapon, secret by 10,000, and where Manzano Mountain boasts to store its dreadful decay through 240 millennia, while our galaxy spirals around its nebulous core. I enter your secret places with my mind. I speak with your presence. I roar your lion roar with mortal mouth. 1 microgram inspired to 1 lung. 10 pounds of heavy metal dust adrift slow motion over gray Alps, the breadth of the planet. How long before your radiance speeds blight and death to sentient beings? Enter my body or not, I carol my spirit inside you. Unapproachable weight, oh heavy, heavy element awakened. I vocalize your consciousness to 6 worlds. I chant your absolute vanity. Yay, monster of anger birthed in fear. Oh, most ignorant matter ever created, unnatural to earth. Delusion of metal empires. Destroyer of lying scientists. Devourer of covetous generals. Incinerator of armies and melter of wars. Judgment of judgments. Divine wind over vengeful nations. Death scandal of capital politics. Molester of presidents. Ah, civilization stupidly industrious. Canker hex on multitudes, learned or illiterate. Manufactured specter of human reason. Oh, solidified imago of practitioners in the black arts, I dare your reality. I challenge your very being. I publish your cause and effect. I turn the wheel of mind on your 300 tons. Your name enters mankind's ear. I embody your ultimate powers. My oratory advances on your vaunted mystery. This breath dispels your braggart fears. I sing your format last behind your concrete and iron walls. Inside your fortress of rubber and nitrogen baths, concrete translucent silicon shields, in filtered cabinets and baths of lathe oil, my voice resounds through robot glove boxes and ingot cans, and echoes in electric vaults inert of atmosphere. I enter with spirit out loud into your fuel rod drums underground, on soundless thrones and beds of lead. Oh, density! This weightless anthem trumpets transcendent through hidden chambers and breaks through iron doors into the infernal room. Over your dreadful vibration, this measured harmony floats, audible. These jubilant tones are honey and milk and wine sweet water poured on the stone block floor. These syllables are barley groats I scatter on your reactor's core. I call your name with hollow vowels. I psalm your fate close by. My breath near deathless ever at your side to spell your destiny. I set this verse prophetic on your mausoleum walls to seal you up eternally with diamond truth. Oh, doomed plutonium. Bard surveys Plutonian history from midnight, lit with mercury vapor street lamps, till in dawn's early light he contemplates a tranquil politic, spaced out between nations' thought forms, proliferating bureaucratic and horrific armed. Satanic industries projected sudden with $500 billion strength around the world. The same time this text is set in Boulder, Colorado, before Front Range of Rocky Mountains, 12 miles north of Rocky Flats nuclear facility in United States, North America, Western Hemisphere of planet Earth, 6 months and 14 days around our solar system in a spiral galaxy, the local year after dominion of the last god Jehovah, 1978, completed as yellow haze dawn clouds brighten east, Denver City, white below, blue sky, transparent, rising empty, deep and spacious to a morning star high over the balcony above some autos, sat with wheels to curb, downhill from Flatiron's jagged pine ridge, sunlit mountain meadows slope to rust-red sandstone cliffs above brick townhouse roofs, as sparrows waked whistling through marine streets, summer green-leafed trees. This ode to you, O poets and orators to come. You, Father Whitman, as I join your side. You, Congress and American people. You, present meditators, spiritual friends and teachers. You, O master of the diamond arts, take this wheel of syllables in hand, these vowels and consonants to breath's end. Take this inhalation of black poison to your heart. Breathe out this blessing from your breast on our creation, forests, cities, oceans, desert, rocky flats and mountains, in the 10 directions, pacify with this exhalation. Enrich this Plutonian ode to explode its empty thunder through earthen thought worlds. Magnetize this howl with heartless compassion. Destroy this mountain of plutonium with ordinary mind and body speech. Thus empower this mind guard spirit gone out, gone out, gone beyond me, into wakened space. So,